Hi, I'm Bob Christina, principal of High Point Central High School. My concern today is that we focus on the quarter cent sales tax that will be coming on the November 4th election. We certainly have a lot of needs here at High Point Central. One of the biggest needs, this fabulous building of ours was built in 1926. I've been told one of the first million-dollar high schools in the state of North Carolina. It's a grand place for our children to learn. But it also has a lot of maintenance issues with it as well. Top of our list on maintenance is the roofing repair that we need and the tremendous cost it takes to repair a roof. And a building like this, it was built in 1926, we have slate tile, which you could say is the Cadillac of roofs. However, to preserve it historically, it takes a considerable amount of funding. And to be able to repair that roof also helps us repair the inside of the auditorium and our gymnasium where we have leaks and other sources of disrepair. In this, you have a 1926 facility, and you have water damage all along the ceiling on where the crown molding is on each side of the building. And you have up on the ceiling, you have cracks, you have different things where the water damage has come through. In each of the corners, there have been a lot of plaster repair as well. We're also looking for repairs for our parking lots, where our students park, where our bus depot is. We also share a campus with another school. So we have over 1,500 kids on our campus in two schools. There's a lot of wear and tear on everyday things that you might not think are big, but certainly help the function of the school. We've had an increase in class size, which is a good thing. That means young people and their families want to come to High Point Central. But with the reduction in the number of available teachers to teach those children, our class sizes have increased. Here at High Point Central, we have classes that average over 30. Also, what has happened is, because of that, and because of the additional requirements that are required by the state of North Carolina for classes that children have to graduate, we've had to reduce the number of AP classes and electives for our children, which means they don't have an opportunity to experience some of the variety of curriculum that's out there to make them better, more well-rounded, and certainly improve their applications for college admissions all across this great state, as well as other states they may be applying to and universities. It's a big problem because of the numbers and because of the reduction in the number of AP classes that we've been able to offer. We're working very, very hard here at High Point Central to make every day a great day for our students and making sure that their future is secure and set. We want a better place for children to come from, and we certainly want a better future for them and a bright future. We're excited about what we're doing and what our teachers are doing and our staff is doing, marvelous work with young people, and we're certainly excited about what our children are doing. We're excited about the future at High Point Central, and certainly additional funds to support that would even make us better.